Afternoon, everyone. It's the 19th of March, 2020. My name is sihova Franciscus, teacher at Zela Tutorial Center. I'm here to present physical science. It's a paper 3. I'm just going to present a component, one of the components in physical science, which is paper 3. In this video, I will only talk about experiments. Since paper 3 questions are basically based on experiments, so I would want you guys to be familiar or to have an idea on how question comes in paper 3. So question in paper 3, like I said, they are based on experiments. They might give you any kind of experiments. Like for example, you can say load, extension less time, the experiment, load, extension less time, or volume less time, speed less time. You can talk about concentration less volume. Those are kind of experiments. So after a certain experiment, then questions arise from there. So I would want you guys to understand what happens or what we should know or what happens before each experiment. Here I have few notes, like what happens before experiments. Before we start experimenting, any experiments that you are given, what we do or what we keep in mind is we make sure the reacted or the quantities of the substances are kept the same at first before you start experimenting. And we can give an example of volume, maybe distance, acids, concentrations. We can talk about time. You should keep it the same at first before you experiment. So I would want you to understand the first point, which is before we start experimenting. The reason of doing this, keeping quantities of substances the same at first before you experiment, there's a reason behind this. So questions in paper 3, they come like, they might ask you to give the reason why certain substances or why time and maybe this volume was kept the same before the experiment. The reason there is to make the experiment fair. It's for fairness, in short, to make the experiment fair. That's the reason. You know, that's when you start experimenting. During the experiment, that's the second point that I'll get you through. What happens during experiments is that as you are experimenting, you will find out at some points that you are not getting the results or you are not seeing things that you expected in the experiment. So what we do or what is always done during the experiment, you try to repeat the experiment several times. There's reason for that as well. So in examinations, paper 3, since ordinary level is just an alternative practical paper, which is paper 3, so you are not going to do this experiment. So experiment, it will be done, and it's going to be done on the question paper for you. Then questions will come, examples on this one during experiment. The reason of repeating experiments several times is for accuracy, to ensure accuracy. Like I said earlier, at certain points you will find out that the result that you are seeing or that it's not the same as the one that you expected to see. So you try to repeat it several times to ensure or for accuracy reason. So the reason for that, a question can come, why was maybe a certain experiment was set there, then they will ask you why, and they will tell you that it was repeated several times. So the question can come, why did they repeat it several times? The only reason there is for accuracy reasons. So we come to, this is during experiments, we come to just before the end of experiment, each experiment. You know, you can start an experiment, but it always comes to an end. So just before the end of experiment, any experiments that you will do, there's something that you are going to see. There's signs that they are going to show just before the end of experiment. So you must be familiar with that one. Okay, you will expect at some point, you expect the experiments to end earlier, or you will find out that the experiment have ended earlier. You will find out that the experiment have ended earlier or sooner than expected. For example, maybe you wanted to experiment velocity versus time for 20 minutes, or maybe you wanted to experiment volume versus time for 20 minutes, but you will find out that it has come to an end maybe 15 minutes or 5 minutes before 20 minutes. So there's reasons for that. So reasons why it happens in that way is maybe one of the reactants, like I said before the experiments, the substances that we use. Okay, if in case you are using volume and time, maybe the reactant or the volume, the quantity of the volume or one of the reactants, it finished before time. So you will see that the experiment is going to end earlier than expected. The results of experiment, any experiments that we do, it's can be given in table format or in a graph format. Meaning any results of any experiments that we do can be represented in a table form or in a graph form. So when it is in a table form, it's always like at ordinary level physical science, it's always you will find the table in the question paper. So all that you will need, maybe they will ask you to fill in the missing values after reading or after getting some values on the table or in any experiment that was already done. So that's how it happens in examination. So in a table format, you'll find out, this is what I was talking about earlier. Like an example here, I have an example for you, a table format, a volume, the reaction with the experiment on the volume, to experiment volume versus time. Okay, at first, you can see that it was kept the same, which is 0, 0. We start at 0, 0. The reason is to make sure that the experiment is fair. Then we repeat it several times, like you are seeing it in the table. The reason is for accuracy, to ensure accuracy. So you can see in the table here, at first the volume it was 0, and came to, they used a 10 cubic centimeter, a 15 cubic centimeter, then a 20, 25, and then the time is, it is showing on the table. So we can present this information as well on the graph. On the graph, we can present, this is just a rough sketch. I only sketch a rough graph just for you to see how it happens. Okay, this is what I explained at first. You'll find out that just before the end of the experiment, like it is shown on the table, you will find out that after 1, 2, 3, 4, times the volume, you can see that it is not changing in the last 3 seconds or in the last 15 seconds. So this is the reason, like the one that I said on point 3. The volume finished, the volume in the reaction finished before time. That's why you are saying after the third, you can see that it was at constant 25, 25, then 25. So this shows that the volume got finished after 15 seconds. The volume got finished after 15 seconds. That's why it is constant in the last three columns. So that's the reason. If we show it on the graph, you can see that from the beginning here at 0, 0, it increased, the volume increased, or the reaction increased, until at a point. This point, after 15 seconds, at this point, the volume gets used up. So as it got used up, you can see that the reaction from there, it stopped. Because even how the time, okay, the time it was still counting, but you can see that the volume, it was not increasing or not increasing. So it was constant for the last few seconds. Okay, this is basically paper three. So you must be familiar with questions like, why should we keep quantities of substances the same at first before experiment, or why should you keep it the same, the reason being for fair results. Okay, why should we repeat experiments when you are experimenting something? It's to ensure accuracy. Or why do we or sometimes find out that experiments ends or it stops before, or it ends sooner or earlier than expected? Always the reason there is because it might be that one of the reactants get used up, or you can use get finished, or you can say if you find out that the reactant, one of the substances that was used is acid, then you can reason that, okay, the acid get used up. If you find out that volume was used, then we can say the volume got used up. Okay, that's the reason why the experiment had to end sooner than expected. Basically, okay, this is paper three. So I only wanted to explain to you on how question comes in paper three. So we should expect kind like these questions in any examination that you are going to sit for in ordinary level physical science grade 12. Thank you very much.